A lot of people have asked me, hey Daniel, is there a way to make like a progress bar or a power bar to go along with my footage in Filmora 9? Well, there actually is. Oops, looks like I'm out of time. Stick around, I'll show you how.
Hit the subscribe button and click the notification bell to be part of the conversation.
This video is sponsored by the good people at Filmora. To create this effect, the first thing you want to do is go up into your upper left into your sample color section. Now you can choose any colors that you want to use for this particular effect, but I'm using green for the actual motion and gray is the background. So let me start by bringing gray down into my timeline. I'm going to stretch that out right across here. And in the track above it, I'm going to bring down the green and stretch that out as well. Now, if you double left click on your green down in the timeline in the upper left, you'll see options for motion. If you scroll down, you'll see an option for move to top. Double left click on that and it will apply it to your green track. Then you can just click OK. Now, when you play your footage, you'll see that this green moves upward in the upper right. But I need a little more motion than that. Let's lock that gray track down in our timeline. Let's left click on the green, and in the upper right in the preview window, let's grab that green track and let's bring it down to somewhere about the middle of this screen. If we rewind and hit play, you'll see that that slowly moves upward. My goal here is to try to get that green to stop right up by the top. I'm a little bit short of that. Let me try this again and let me move it just a hair higher. And play it again and watch right where it stops at the top. And when it gets there, I want you to stop your footage. Right there. Let's slice both the gray and the green footage here and we can get rid of everything at the end. Now let's export this footage just as it is. I call this bouncing, when you send something out mixed so you can bring it back in later to use again. Let's keep our settings fairly high. I'm gonna go for a full 60 frames per second on 80,000 kbps. I want this to be really crisp. Now back in our project, let's bring that back in and we can eliminate the stuff in our timeline. Bring your footage down into your timeline and find where in your footage you want that progress bar to start. If you know that you want your progress bar to exist for about 10 seconds, what you want to do is bring that green motion track down into a track above your timeline, right-click on it, choose speed and duration, and then set the motion for 10 seconds. And click OK. That'll take that motion and spread it out so it exists for about 10 seconds. Now here's the cool trick. Let's lock our main footage, left click on our green motion, and up in the preview window, let's move this over and slide it into a narrower band. Now I did a vertical bar, but you can do this horizontally if you want, simply by grabbing that and rotating it to where you need it to be. But for this case, I'm gonna do a vertical bar. Let's get that somewhere to the size we think it might want to be. Now in this case, the green is actually moving upward. I want it to move downward, so I'm gonna right click on that, choose speed and duration again, and click reverse speed. That'll spin that motion around, so now it starts moving downward. Now you could resize this and move it however you want. I actually wanna put a little bit of a background behind this, so let me grab that and move it into one track above. Go back into the upper left, grab the sample colors, and bring down the black. And let's stretch that out for the entire length of this progress bar. Now, just like before, let's left click on the black track and let's resize it up above so it just sort of outlines this thing and makes it look more like an actual progress bar. Now, if I click play, that will start to move downward over the amount of time that I set in the speed and duration. Now, one of the other tricks that I had done is I actually used titles to create some names, the start and the end next to that. You can do that really easily just by clicking on the titles tab, going to titles, and bringing something down into a track above this. Let's name that start. Now, I also created a little scale to make it look like it was measuring some actual increments of time. And that was another simple cool trick I did just by grabbing another title track, bringing that down above the other tracks that are in existence right now, stretching it out, and up in the left, instead of putting in words, I used the underscore. And I just kept returning and entering that over and over again. Let me shrink that down into something I can use. I'm going to left click and invert it so it's over here. And I'll stick it right under the word start. And now it looks like I've actually got some kind of gauges that's measuring absolutely nothing. But it helps pull this effect off and makes it look a little cooler. Try this trick yourself at home and see how you can use it in different ways to make your project look cool. If you want to learn more Filmora tips, tricks, and techniques, click on the video on screen now or the ones that I'll link down below. Peace.